Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play Daiva 5 for the MSX. Now as you can see I've been playing a couple turns since the last video. I killed off most of the planets on the bottom left and went on to conquer three of the planets closest to the enemy's home base. And the reason for that is probably pretty obvious. We want to try and limit his production capacity as much as possible. Taking those three planets means he has very little income to work with. So we should have no trouble keeping him in check now. I've also parked my primary fleet up here on his main planet, which means we will be able to pick off any fleets he builds, any new fleets he decides to build. He's been busy, as you can see. He's got three fleets up here, although they are pretty weak. So the first thing I'm going to do now is use my main fleet to take out, hopefully, most of his forces up here. Yeah, this should be pretty easy. He's only got one battleship, we've got four. We've also got four cruisers to his two, and we've got plenty of little guys to back us up. Now I do want to be a little bit careful because it is possible if he moves his battleship behind his cruiser that I'll take out his cruiser, but he'll kill my battleship in return. So what I think I'll do first is move my guys out of the way a bit and make sure they don't get killed in the first turn. And then hopefully he will move his ships in such a way that I can take them out without taking any losses. Let's see. This guy is safe. This guy is a little bit threatened. If he leaves his cruiser here and he moves his battleship up here, that means his cruiser gets to fire first. It'll damage my battleship a little bit. Then my battleship will get to fire on his cruiser, which will get taken out, but it'll absorb enough damage to protect this guy from dying. And this guy, being located back here, will easily be able to take out my battleship in return. So I think before I commit to that, I will move them out of the way and see what kind of moves he makes first. This is actually very convenient for me. He moved his cruisers in such a way that they will be instantly taken out by my battleships, which happened just now, which means his battleship is more or less unprotected. Now, unless I get very unlucky and he moves it back into the front line, which is pretty rare, he usually does, computer enemies don't usually do that, I'll be able to take out his battleship without him having a significant chance of killing mine. First, let's try to take out these little guys. Oops, he did in fact move it up front. That's a bit annoying. That means we lose one battleship, but in return we take out his entire fleet, so I think that's, overall, that's pretty much worth it. At least, hopefully, unless we get a couple unlucky misses, but no. That'll do it. So trading one battleship for an entire fleet, or in fact actually two entire fleets in this case, that's worth it, I think. Okay, so he's moved his remaining fleet down over here, which means I will have to... I can either move one of my other fleets back here, back to the central planet to protect it, but that means he has a chance of moving to one of the other ones. So instead of that, I think I will use my newly built ships to create a new fleet to protect that third central planet. And what we will call it... Why not? Get some cool sounding names. And we will assign both our cruisers and five each of these. That should be enough. And he's building a new fleet already. Let's have a quick look what it's like. Okay, it's not too strong. It's not completely weak, but... let's take out the stronger one first. If they are really small fleets, I tend to ignore them, but when they contain battleships, I think it's worth rushing them down. Okay, let's get these guys into place. Again, this is a little bit risky because he might take out my battleship by moving his behind his cruiser and using it as a shield, but Oh, actually, this is a little bit unlucky too. He's now using the. I got a lucky hit there. He was using the asteroids for cover, which normally would be enough, but I think it's due to my high morale that my damage output is much higher than his. So my lasers were enough to take him out, even though my missiles were blocked by those asteroid fields. So with any luck, yeah, he'll stay in place. And we will demolish him. There we go. Wish I knew what these messages meant. I might actually take some time to translate them later and put up some annotations or something, but no promises. First of all, my Japanese is terrible. I can only translate it word for word using a dictionary. And of course that takes forever, so it, yeah, maybe if I have time, but don't hold me to that. Do I want to take out his final fleet? I do kind of want to prevent it from running away somewhere else and being annoying later, so let's get rid of this one too. At least hopefully, because I don't know if I'll be, yeah. Positioning is going to be everything in this fight. And for the first round, I'm going to get out of his way and see how he moves. Usually, if they move in a certain sort of strategy in the first turn, they will stick to that strategy for the remaining turns. So they might move slightly, but usually not a lot. So in this case, yeah. There is a very good chance he won't move away from this location, so I'm going to use my laser guys as a meat shield here. With any luck, they will be enough to take him out. Yeah, this should be okay. Yeah, this will definitely be okay. Yep. Okay, he lost a couple of small ships, but nothing interesting. And again, he's going to annoy me with another new fleet, another battleship. Okay, one more time. And after this one, we're going to be focusing a little bit more on retaking a bunch of these planets that we lost. I'm just doing this video in between because I wanted to show you a little bit about of the progress I've been making. Before the next one, I'll probably play ahead a little bit further again. Ooh, lucky there. Show you the next step in the story, basically. This game, there are a number of set actions that you have to take to finish it properly. Which, I'll be perfectly honest, I've never actually managed to complete yet. I've gotten the bad ending a couple of times, but the good ending, there's a little bit of luck involved, I think. But there's also a couple of things you have to do in a specific order, which is very hard to know if you don't speak Japanese. One of the things you have to do is conquer quite a lot of the planets, I believe, before you head for planet number two, which is Bleeder, this one over here. And yeah, I'll show you when I'm ready to get to that step. Okay, so now he's down to using really tiny little fleets of three small fighter ships in this case. So we'll be able to contain that pretty easily. Okay, guys, I'm running out of time for this part, so I'm going to end it here for now. Like I said, in the next video, I'll probably be quite a bit further. Hopefully, I'll have co conquered a bunch of these neutral planets. And I will, with any luck, show you the next step in our story, taking Planet Bleeder and using it to upgrade our fleet. Okay, guys, thanks for watching again, and I'll see you in the next part.